Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will discuss the edge parameters of the two-port network. So in electronics, the edge parameters are very useful in determining some of the amplifier characteristics. For example, it is very useful in determining the input and output impedance as well as the voltage and current gain of the amplifier. And in fact, these edge parameters are very useful during the small signal analysis of the transistor. So now, let us see how the voltage and current of the two-port network can be expressed in terms of the edge parameters. So we know that the two-port network has four variables. That means V1 and I1 on the port 1 side, while the V2 and I2 on the port 2 side. And out of the four variables, the two variables are the independent variables, while the remaining two are the dependent variables. So for the edge parameter, the I1 and V2 are the independent variables, while the V1 and I2 are the dependent variables. That means V1 and I2 are the function of I1 and V2, and they can be expressed in terms of the I1 and V2. So for the edge parameters, the V1 can be expressed as H11 times I1 plus H12 times V2. Similarly, the I2 can be expressed as H21 times I1 plus H22 times V2, where these H11, H12, H21 and H22 are the proportionality coefficients and they are known as the edge parameters. So these two expressions can also be expressed in terms of the matrix form. That means V1 and I2 is equal to the matrix of the edge parameters times I1 and V2. So now, let us see how we can find the individual edge parameters. So first of all, to find the H11 and the H21, let us make this voltage V2 is equal to 0. Or in other words, let us short circuit this port 2. So in this condition, the first expression can be written as voltage V1 is equal to H11 times I1. Or we can say that H11 is equal to V1 divided by I1. Now if you see the unit of this parameter, then it has a unit of impedance. And while finding this parameter, this voltage V2 is equal to 0. Or in other words, the port 2 is short circuited. So this parameter is known as the short circuit input impedance. Similarly, when the voltage V2 is equal to 0, then from the second expression, we can write current I2 is equal to H21 times I1. Or we can say that H21 is equal to I2 divided by I1. So here, the current in the numerator is on the port 2 side, while the current in the denominator is on the port 1 side. And if you see the unit of this parameter, then it is the unitless parameter. And while finding this parameter, the port 2 is short circuited. That means the voltage V2 is equal to 0. So this H21 is known as the short circuit forward current gain. Similarly, the H12 and the H22 can be found whenever this current I1 is equal to 0. Or in other words, when the port 1 is open circuited. So whenever this current I1 is equal to 0, then from the first expression, we can write voltage V1 is equal to H12 times V2. Or we can say that H12 is equal to V1 divided by V2. So here in the numerator, the voltage is on the port 1 side, while in the denominator, the voltage is on the port 2 side. And once again, if you see the unit of this parameter, then it is the unitless parameter. And while finding this parameter, the port 1 is open circuited. Or in other words, the I1 is equal to 0. So this parameter H12 is known as the open circuit reverse voltage gain. And likewise, when current I1 is equal to 0, then from the second expression we can write the current I2 is equal to H22 times V2. Or in other words, H22 is equal to I2 divided by V2. So this parameter relates the output current with the output voltage. And at that time, the current I1 is equal to 0. or the port 1 is open circuited. And also if you see the unit of this parameter, then it has a unit of admittance. So this parameter H22 is known as the open circuit output admittance. And here is the representation of all four parameters. So as you can see, all four parameters have the different unit. For example, the H11 has a unit of impedance while the H22 has the unit of admittance. On the other end, this H21 and the H12 are the unitless parameters. So because of that, these parameters are known as the hybrid parameters because each parameter has the different unit. So now, let us see the equivalent circuit of the two port network in terms of the H parameters. So from the first expression, if we see the equivalent circuit on the port 1 side, then it will look like this. So basically, if we apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law on the port 1 side of this equivalent circuit, then we will get this first expression. So here, this H11I1 is the voltage drop across this impedance H11, while this H12V2 is the voltage controlled voltage source. That means the value of this voltage source depends on the voltage at the port 2. Similarly, from the second expression, if we see the equivalent circuit on the port 2 side, then it will look like this. So basically, if we apply the Kirchhoff's current law on the port 2 side of this equivalent circuit, then we will get this second expression. So here, this H22 represents the admittance, while this H21I1 is the current controlled current source. And the value of this current source depends on the current at the port 1 side. So this is the equivalent circuit of the two port network in terms of the H parameters. Now, similar to the Z and the Y parameters, let us see the condition of reciprocity and the symmetry of the two port network in terms of these H parameters. And first of all, let us see the condition of reciprocity. So let's say we have applied the voltage Vs on the port 1 side and we are measuring the short circuit current at the port 2. Now if the network is reciprocal, then we should get the same short circuit current at the port 1 whenever we apply the supply voltage Vs at the port 2. Or in other words, a network is said to be a reciprocal if the ratio of excitation at the one port to the response at the other port is same if the excitation and the response are interchanged. So in terms of the H parameters, the two port network is said to be a reciprocal if H12 is equal to minus H21. So if we know the H parameters of any network and if this condition gets satisfied, then we can say that the given two port network is the reciprocal network. So now let us prove this condition. So let's say we have applied the supply voltage Vs on the port 1 side and we are measuring the short circuit current at the port 2. That means here voltage V1 is equal to Vs while the voltage V2 is equal to 0. And here this current I2 is equal to minus I2 dash. So from this, the first expression can be written as voltage Vs is equal to H11 times I1. And similarly, the second expression can be written as minus I2 dash is equal to H21 times I1. So if we take the ratio of these two expressions, then we can write voltage Vs divided by minus I2 dash is equal to H11 divided by H21. Or we can say that voltage Vs divided by I2 dash is equal to minus H11 divided by H21. And let's say this is the first equation. Similarly, now let us say the voltage is applied at the port 2 and we are measuring the short circuit current at the port 1. So in this condition, the voltage V2 is equal to Vs while the voltage V1 is equal to 0. And here, this current I1 is equal to minus I1 dash. So putting these values in the first expression, we can write 0 is equal to minus H11 times I1 dash plus H12 times Vs. Or we can say that Vs divided by I1 dash is equal to H11 divided by H12. And let's say this is the second equation. Now, if the network is reciprocal, then this equation 1 and 2 should be equal. Or in other words, the H11 divided by H12 should be equal to minus H11 divided by H21. That means H21 should be equal to minus H12. That means if this condition gets satisfied, then we can say that the network is the reciprocal network. So similarly, now let us see the condition for the symmetry. So a two-port network is said to be a symmetrical network if the ratio of voltage to the current at the one port is same as the ratio of voltage to the current at the other port with one of the port is open circuited. That means if the network is symmetrical, then the ratio of V1 and I1 when current I2 is equal to 0 should be same as the V2 divided by I2 whenever current I1 is equal to 0. So now let us find the condition for symmetry in terms of the H parameters. And for that, first of all, let us find the ratio of V1 and I1. So for that, let us assume that the port 2 is open circuited, or in other words, this current I2 is equal to 0. So from the second expression, we can write 0 is equal to H21 times I1 plus H22 times V2. Now here, as we are interested in finding the ratio of V1 and I1, so let's find the value of voltage V2 in terms of the I1. So we can say that the voltage V2 is equal to minus of H21 divided by H22 times I1. And now let us put the value of V2 in this first expression. That means voltage V1 is equal to H11 times I1 plus H12 times minus of H21 divided by H22 times I1. Or we can say that the ratio of V1 and I1 is equal to H11 times H22 minus H12 times H21 divided by H22. And let's say this is the third expression. Similarly, to find the ratio of V2 and I2, let us assume that the current I1 is equal to 0. So from the second expression, we can write I2 is equal to 0 plus H22 times V2. That means ratio of V2 and I2 when current I1 is equal to 0 is equal to 1 divided by H22. And let's say this is the fourth expression. So if the network is symmetrical, then these two ratios should be equal. Or in other words, this H11 times H22 minus H12 times H21 should be equal to 1. Or in other words, we can say that the delta H should be equal to 1. So if this condition gets satisfied, then we can say that the network is symmetrical network. So this is all about the H parameters. And we will discuss more about it during the small signal analysis of the BJT. But I hope in this video you understood how to find the H parameters for the two-port network. So if you have any questions or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.